Good morning. Today is 3rd April and this is Friday. It is Friday. So, we are going to continue with the binomial expansion of negative index. Negative index or fractional index. Yesterday, I gave you the formula of writing the binomial expansion. The formula, in the binomial, first of all, we have to make sure that the first term is always 1. Right? For the negative index or for the fractional index, in the binomial, the first term must be always 1, number 1. Then after that, we can go for the binomial expansion. When you go for the binomial expansion, the pattern is first term is always 1, then is nx, then is n into n minus 1 factorial 2 into x square, then n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 into x cube over factorial 3 and so on, right? So here you can notice here that the n terms are the factors and the number of factors will gradually increase, right? Here we have one, and then there here in the third term we have two factor, here we have three factor, then we will have four factor and so on. It will go on increasing. Similarly, the power, the degree of x also will go on increasing. This degree of this x is 1, degree of this is 2, the degree of this x is 3, and then next the degree of x will be 4, and so on it will increase. So we will just follow this track, okay? We will follow this track and we will try to write the binomial expansion. Is it okay? Now, this is your question. This is your question. This is the binomial whose degree is negative. So we are going to write the binomial expansion. But here in this question there is a problem. Because we want for the negative index or for the fractional index, we always expect the first term of the binomial to be 1. But here, the first term of the binomial is not 1. Right? Therefore, it's very necessary that you make the first term of this binomial as 1. And only then you can proceed. So, we are going to do that first of all. We are going to modify the question. We will rectify the question. Now, we want this to be 1. Therefore, this has to come out. So, If you take out the first term of your binomial, only then this can be made into 1. Clear? So this is the process. The step number 1 is you take it out, right? Now, and then inside you will write down the remaining part where the first term will become 1. Clear? Now, this 2x you have taken out from the bracket, right? And the degree of that bracket is negative 2. So therefore, the degree of this also will be same as the degree of your binomial. Anything that will come out will have the same degree. Okay? Now, next, you can write remaining in the bracket. The first term will obviously then become 1, then plus, and second term will become a over whatever you have taken out. Look at the base. What you have taken out? 2x. So 2x will come in the denominator. And then this is degree minus. So your question is now modified, is made appropriate for now. The question is ready for the binomial expansion, where the first term is 1, degree negative. We can now proceed because the question is complete. We are going to use these two values, right? N value is the degree negative 2, and x the second term. We always suppose the second term to be x in the general formula. Therefore, the value of x is a over 2x. Can you see this? Now, let us start the question. Now, when you are writing the binomial expansion, you will expand only the binomial. We will not do anything with this one. This will remain as it is from beginning till the end. Okay? So, this is 2x. 2x to the power negative 2. Now, remaining. First, 1 plus nx, n is negative 2, x is a over 2x, your nx is done. Now n into n minus 1 plus n negative 2, n minus 1, negative 2 minus 1 divided by factorial 2, then x square, and your x is a over 2x square plus n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 now. So minus 2 is n, then n minus 1, so minus 2 minus 1, then n minus 2, so minus 2 minus 2 divided by factorial 3, then x cube, so it is a over 2x cube and so on. Clear? We are asked to calculate only the first four terms of the expansion. So the expansion is done. This rule is now followed. Binomial expansion is now over, completed. After this is only operation, simplification. This is 2x to the power negative 2. Now this is 1. Let us simplify. These two cancel these two, right? Your term will become negative because of this minus sign. A over x. Done? Now from here, in this part, total number of negative quantity is 2. Because minus 2 minus 1 will become minus 3 and this is minus 2. So overall there are 2 negative quantity, therefore the result will be positive. So positive, right? This is 3, this is 2, so this is 6, right? Now denominator, you write this 2 as 2 only, because the factorial of 2, when you write this in the product form, it will be 2. So 2 into 1 is 2. Now this is a square, and down in the denominator will become 4x square. Is it alright? Now, next one. From this total, there are 3 negative quantity. This will be negative 4, this will be negative 3, this will be negative 2. So total there are 3 negative quantity in this part, therefore the result of this part will be negative. Now let us write the product. This is 4, 3s are 12, 2s are 24. This is 24. Denominator, we will write this in the form of product. So this is 3, factorial means 3, 2s are 6. And then we will write the result of a over 2x whole cube. This will be a cube. Then we will have cube of 2 is 8, 8x cube plus so on. Is equal to now 2x negative 1 over 2. Sorry, negative 2. Now 1 minus a over x as it is. This part 2, 3 is a 6. 2, 3 is a 6. Now nothing can be simplified. Plus 3 over 4 a square 6 a square x square minus 6 4s are 24. Clear? 4 2s are 8. Therefore, answer is a cube over 2x cube. And so on. Alright, after this now at the end, this power was always negative, 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 no? We can make this power positive. We can make this power positive by writing this in the denominator. You know the exponential rule, you have studied in class 9. If you want to make the power, if you want to change the sign of the power, you have to change the position of the number. So we can write this as 1 over 2x to the power 2. Okay? Now, take it inside and multiply with all the terms, and that will be your final answer. So this into this is 1 over 2x square. We can write this as 4x square. Better you write this as 4x square. Now this into this, minus a over 4x square into x. This is 4x cube. 4x cube. Next one is plus 3 over 4 and into this will become 4. This is 4. So this will be 16. This will be 16. With this 4 will be multiplied. So 16, then numerator you have a square, and then this x square and this x square, will become x to the power 4 minus, once again, this is a cube over, this is 4, this is 2, this is 8, x square, and this is x cube. So this will become x to the power 5. This way, this became your first 5 term of the binomial expansion. Hope this is clear. This is the second question of the same type. Here, you can see again the first term is not 1. The power is fractional number, right? But the first term is not 1. Therefore, this question also we need to modify. We will modify. In the previous question, you may remember what I told you, how we have made this as 1, right? So, whatever is this will come out. X cube. Clear? This is just first term. X cube is the first term. Now, this x cube will be given the power, which is the power of the bracket. So, we will give the bracket power 1 over 3. Clear? And now, remaining we will write inside the bracket. Because you have already taken out the first term of the bracket, therefore this will turn into 1. And now, minus 1 over. Now, whatever you have taken out will go in the denominator of the second term. This is already x, and further you are giving, supplying this to x cube, so this becomes x to the power 4. And then power is 1 over 3. Hope this is very, very clear to you all. Is it okay? Okay. Now, after doing this, we will, for this binomial, we will write down the value of the n and the value of x. So, the value of n is the degree, which is equal to 1 over 3. I already wrote. Now, the second term is 1 over x to the power, we'll write this as minus, we'll write this second term as minus 1 over x to the power 4. So, this is your second term. Now, we can start. These questions we have to do a little bit carefully. X cube. Okay, now this x cube and then 1 over 3. When you open the bracket, the 2 power will be multiplied, isn't it? When the 2 power is multiplied, right, we will write like this. And then I am just going to expand the inside term. We are going to expand it. First term is 1, then plus nx. Nx, n is 1 over 3 and x is negative 1 over x to the power 4. Nx is done. Now plus n into n minus 1. That is 1 over 3 into 1 over 3 minus 1. Then divided by factorial 2. Factorial 2. X square, that means minus 1 over x to the power 4 and its square. Last one is plus n, that is 1 over 3, then is n minus 1, so 1 over 3 minus 1, then is n minus 2, it is 1 over 3 minus 2, right? Then divided by factorial 3, factorial 3. X cube is again minus 1 over x to the power 4 and then to the power 3. This way, it will, expansion will continue. Here we are going to write only the first 4 term. That is why always I am writing only the 4 term. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now, here, this 3 and this 3 is cancelled. So, in the next step, finally, I have only x. Now, expansion is done. Expansion you will have only in one step. The remaining step, we have to do only the simplification part. So, I am now going to simplify. This is 1 as such minus, multiply the 2 fractional number. You know how to multiply the 2 fractional number? Numerator multiplied by numerator and denominator multiplied by denominator. So this is 1 over 3x to the power 4. Alright? Now, this one. This will give you minus 2 over 3. This will give you minus 2 over 3. So this is one negative quantity. This will become positive. So the overall there is only one negative quantity. Therefore, the result of this part, second, third part will be negative. Alright, now I will write this. This is 2 over 3. This is now minus sign already I wrote. Therefore, I will not talk about the max sign now. 2 over 3 and 1 over 3. So this will become 2 over 9. This will become 2 over 9. 2 over 3 and 1 over 3. The product will become 2 over 9. Is it alright? Then I will write this factorial as a product. So this is 2 only. And this 2 then I change to division. So it will become as 1 over 2. This will become positive. So this is, we are simply writing this as 1 over x to the power 4 square. That is x to the power 8. Clear? Third term is also done. Now the last term. This will give you negative 2 over 3. This is 1 over 3. This gives you negative 2 over 3. And this gives you negative 5 over 3. Negative 5 over 3. Is this okay? So this is one negative quantity, this is one negative quantity. And this also is negative quantity because the power is odd number. Therefore, ultimately the product of this all will be equal is negative. Okay. So now first of all let us simplify. We have everything. So 5 to the 10. And in the denominator we will write this as 3 into 3 into 3. That is 27. Am I understood now? Now I am going to write this product, factorial 3. As the product, which will go, that will go upside down. So into 3 to the 6. And then finally this one. This is 1 over x to the power 12. Plus, so on it will continue. So simplification also almost is now finishing. 2 3s are 6 and 2 5s are 10. 2 2s are cancelled. So cancellation also done. Now just let us take this inside and write the final answer. So this is, when you multiply this x by 1, it becomes x. Now this will be, this is x over 3x to the power 4. So simplify and then this will come as 1 over 3x cube. Okay. Next time don't ask me that, sir, how come this becomes 3x cube? Because we are multiplying 1 over 3x to the power 4 by x. So numerator x will come in the numerator. Therefore, after cancellation, it is the balance answer. Minus 1 over 9 x to the power 7, because this x will be in the numerator, therefore after simplifying it will turn into this minus 5 over 81, and this is, it will become x to the power 11. Clear? This is your final answer. Here I would like to tell you, sometime in the book you might see this answer taken in the numerator, right? Taken in the numerator. It is up to you. It's not necessary. You can leave the answer into this format, right? Or if you are taking it in the numerator also, it will be correct. You will get the same marks, right? Only the thing is, when you take this all in the numerator, the sign of this, all the powers will change. Is it alright? So this is your second example of this type for the negative index. Thank you. Alright, now this is the last question for the day. This is little peculiar binomial, no? Because we have never met with this kind of binomial where it is given in the form of a fraction number. So, it is not doable, no? We have to have this in the proper format. So, what we can do is, we will modify this question. And then we can write first of all this as 2x minus 1 to the power negative 2. We did one step and we have modified. But yet this is not in the proper form. It's because you might have noticed that when you are expanding a binomial in a negative index or fractional index, then the first term is supposed to be 1. First term is supposed to be 1. But our first term has gone in the second position. So we need to again make some changes in this question. This comes as, in place of this, we can write this as minus 1 plus 2x. Whole to the power negative 2. Is it understood now? Still there is a problem. That the first term is 1. But it should be always positive 1 only. Therefore, we will take out this minus sign common from here. So it will come out as minus 1 with the same power as this minus 2. And then the remaining we will write inside. So 1. And then this minus sign will go with this also. Because you have taken out the minus sign common. So this is minus 2x to the power negative 2. Now this is our question, which is in the appropriate form. We can now use the binomial expansion. So we are going to start the binomial expansion. This is minus 1 to the power minus 2. Okay. This is now. First term is always 1. Then is second term nx. So plus nx. Here I need to give you the value of n and x. Right? N and x. So let me make some space here. The value of your n is negative 2 and your x is negative 2x. Always make a habit of writing this, no? Our work becomes more easy. Even I also feel comfortable. That is why I am also writing all the time this way. So this is minus 1 to the power negative 2. Then 1 minus, okay, 1, this is, first term is 1. Then is nx, that is minus 2 and minus 2x, nx plus n into n minus 1. N means minus 2, n minus 1 is minus 2 minus 1 divided by factorial 2 into x square, that is negative 2x square plus n into n minus 1 into n minus 2. So n means minus n minus 2, n minus 1, that is this, n minus 2, that is this, divided by factorial 3, factorial 3 into x square. This is x square. Now we will write x cube. So this is minus 2x cube. And then this way it will continue. Alright? This will continue. Next step. Okay, you want to make this power positive, right? So we can write this as 1 over negative 1 to the power 2. Is it okay? 1 plus 4x. Now, this will be positive and the product of these two also will become positive. So ultimately the product of this all will be positive. This will be 4, 4, 3 is 12, 12, 2 is 24, 24 divided by 12. Okay, 24x square, let me write one step, 24x square divided by 2, because factorial 2 will be seen as 2, 2 into 1 is 2. Now here, this is negative, this is also negative, right? So there are 3 negative, and this also will remain negative. Why? Because the power is a odd number. Therefore, ultimately there are 4 negative quantity, so the product of all this will be positive. This is 8. This is 4. 8 for the 32. Then this is 3 into 2. 3 into 6. 3 into 2, 6. And 8 for the 32. So 32 into 6. If I am not wrong. 6 to the 12. 6 to the 18 and 1, 19. 192. Plus 192. And then down we will have 6. Okay. Or maybe what we can do is, this is 8, right? To make the work more easy, why to have so much of calculation? We will write this as 2, okay? Positive 2, this is positive 3. And the remaining will multiply, 8 for the 32, into 32, divided by this 3 factorial, 3 into 2, into 1. Now you might have understood that why I didn't multiply. And this is x cube. Right, we are asked to write only the first 4 term, therefore we are stopping it here. Now, this will become positive, no? This will become positive, and 1 over 1 means 1 only. So there is nothing to multiply, just simplify. 3 2s are cancelled, 2 12s are answer. So final answer is 1 plus 4x plus 12x square plus 32x cube. This is your final answer. Is it okay? Thank you. Have a nice day. Take care. Stay at home.